In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The grace and the peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters in Christ, today the Church celebrates the memorial of St. Barnabas the Apostle. To prepare ourselves to worthily celebrate the sacred mystery, let us call to mind our saints. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask the Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May the Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. O God, who decreed that St. Barnabas, a man filled with faith and the Holy Spirit, should be set apart to convert the nations, grant that the gospel of Christ, which is strenuously preached, may be faithfully proclaimed by word and by deed. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, the Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. In those days, a great number that believed turned to the Lord. News of this came to the ears of the church in Jerusalem, and they sent Barnabas to Antioch. When he came and saw the grace of God, he was glad, and he exhorted them all to remain faithful to the Lord with steadfast purpose. For he was a good man, full of the Holy Spirit and of faith. And a large company was added to the Lord. So Barnabas went to Tarsus to look for Saul. And when he had found him, he brought him to Antioch. For a whole year they met with the church and taught a large company of people. And in Antioch, the disciples were for the first time called Christians. Now in the church at Antioch there were prophets and teachers: Barnabas, Simeon who was called Niger, Lucius of Cyrene, Manaen, a member of the court of Herod, the Tetrarch, and Saul. While they were worshipping the Lord and fasting, the Holy Spirit said, "Set apart for me Barnabas and Saul for the work to which I have called them." Then, after fasting and praying, they laid their hands on them and sent them off. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our response to the psalm is, "The Lord has shown his deliverance to the nations."
The Lord has shown.
The Lord has shown his deliverance to the nations.
The Lord has shown his deliverance to the nations.
Oh, sing a new song to the Lord, for he has worked wonders. His right hand and his holy arm have brought salvation.
The Lord has shown his deliverance to the nations.
The Lord hath made known his salvation, has shown his deliverance to the nations. He has remembered his merciful love and his truth for the house of Israel.
The Lord has shown his deliverance to the nations.
All the ends of the earth have seen the salvation of our God. Shout to the Lord, all the earth. Break forth into joyous song and sing out your praise.
The Lord has shown his deliverance to the nations.
Sing songs to the Lord with the harp and the sound of song, with trumpets and the sound of the horn. Raise a shout before the King, the Lord.
The Lord has shown his deliverance to the nations.
Let us rise for the gospel acclamation.
Alleluia,
alleluia.
Choked
by the thoughts and the cares of this world. So when Barnabas went to Antioch, he saw and he rejoiced, but he rejoiced with caution. And I think that that is the wisdom that Barnabas, you know, expects of us today. That when we rejoice at any kind of victory that we have attained in our lives, when we are happy and we celebrate at having achieved some form of success, let us remember that we must do that with caution. Because whenever there is a victory, it is time for you to sharpen your sword. It's not the time for you to relax and think that you have arrived, whether in spiritual matters or in your secular daily life. Whenever you gain something spiritually, the devil becomes awake. He becomes stirred. In fact, attention is drawn to you by such a victory. So make an effort in your daily life to grow spiritually. But whenever you see that you have gained, whenever you see that you have grown, whenever you see that you have increased even a single notch higher than where you used to be, then you must sharpen your senses, your spiritual senses. The word of the Lord says that anyone who thinks he stands, let him beware lest he fall. Barnabas is called the son of encouragement because the new converts who think that they stand, who think that they have arrived spiritually, they need encouragement so that they do not fall back. The real danger is the danger of backsliding. The real danger is the danger of feeling that you are in a good place. But in actual fact, danger is knocking around the corner. And so let us pray through the grace of this Mass that we too, like St. Barnabas, will be people of encouragement, will help those who are trying to find their faith spiritually. And as we do so, that the Almighty God will grant us also grace so that after having labored, we too will not lose our eternal heritage. May He bless His word in our hearts this afternoon through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Hymn number 67A, 67A.
What a blessed Lord is mine. Thank you.
Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make for the best of all the gifts of prayer. By sending down the Spirit upon them like a dewfall, so that the name come for us, the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and gave thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Once more, giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Mystery of faith, we proclaim the death of the Lord and profess the resurrection until we come again. Therefore, celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection. We offer you, Lord, bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly, we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring us to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, and Alfred Martin, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who are dying in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray. That be the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, the Blessed Jesus, our spouse, the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be glorious in eternal life, and the present glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil." Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days. That by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope of the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours and ours forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant our peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit, Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter my life, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Electronic worship basis
business, which means you will not have any kind of contact with them, and also provision of hand sanitizers. We encourage parishioners to also come with their personal ones. We have provided also thermal guns for temperature checks. The seats in the church will be numbered, and also we'll have space markers to ensure that there is adequate physical distancing. Also, all parishioners are expected to do a pre-registration. This is to enable proper data collection as required by the government for contact tracing. And when we come to church, there will be on-site screening to ensure strict adherence to the recommended safety guidelines and procedures. So before we come from Mass, it is important that we do the registration to secure a Mass slot and a seat number. You can register through any of these means, preferably through the Host Sanctus app. Please do well to download it if you haven't. Or you make a call or an SMS to the numbers that will be disseminated on our parish social media handles. Also, you can send us a mail, cctvgc2018@gmail.com. We also have that in our social media handles. The pre-registration for Mass will commence on Friday, the 12th of June. Why prior registration is necessary? This is because we need it for contact tracing, and we need it for adequate planning. Also, each Mass has a maximum capacity and seat allocation, so you need to register before coming for Mass. And when you register, you will be issued an entry pass or a permit. Now, for our Masses, the Mass schedule. The church at the overflow will have 7 a.m. to 8 a.m. You will notice that there is a 1 hour interval between every Mass. That is to ensure that there is complete disinfection and sanitization before the next Mass. So the first Mass is 7 to 8 a.m. in the main church and in the overflow. Then 1 hour later, we'll have another Mass here, 9 a.m. to 10 a.m. 1 hour later, another Mass, 11 a.m. to 12 noon. In between, there will be a Mass in the children's hall at 8 a.m. to 9 a.m. and then at 10 a.m. to 11 a.m. Parishioners are encouraged to come along with their personal hymn books, missals, and other materials. Our usual communal hymn books will not be available as a safety precaution to curb the spread of the infection. And also, parishioners are asked to wear face masks during their stay within the premises, inside and outside the church building. There should be no hugging and no handshakes. And reception of Holy Communion is strictly on the palm. After the Mass, there should be no congregation of any kind. There are age restrictions. Those under 15 and above 65 years are not allowed to church during this period. We will provide for those within this age bracket live streaming, online streaming of our Masses, so that you can watch while you are at home. For those also who are not allowed in church during this period, we have also the nursing mothers, those who are sick, people with underlying health conditions. Finally, Just as a recap, please, before you enter the church, you have to have a face mask and also there will be temperature checks. You wash your hands with soap and water and use a hand sanitizer. And then you present your entry permit. And then no communication after Mass. We ask that the Almighty God bless us and grant us complete safety as we reopen the churches through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. May the blessings and the peace of the Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down upon you and remain with you now and forever.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God. 335 from the Catholic Hymnbook, hymn number 335.